When examining a patient with esophagitis, several questions must be answered before the correct diagnosis can be made. First, is esodeviation is comitant or incomitant? Comitance means that the angle of deviation in the same in different directions of gaze. But remember that small differences in the angle of strabismus in different gazes are common and not inconsistent with the diagnosis of comitant strabismus. Second question, the age of onset of the esophagitis. An esophagitis confirmed by the observer before the age of 6 months, this narrows the diagnosis to only a few possibilities that will be discussed later. That's the esodeviation in the first 6 months of life. While an acute esophagitis appears in elder patients, also narrows the diagnosis to several neurological diseases. Unlike the exodeviations, which are frequently intermittent or latent, most esodeviations are manifest. Next question. Is the angle of the esodeviation is affected by the accommodation and convergence or not? Next to be answered, is the angle of deviation is different from at near fixation to at far fixation or not? An esodeviation is frequently greater at near than at distance. That's because of the effect of accommodation and the proximal convergence. In patients with an esophagitis, greater at near than at distance fixation, the effect of the AC to A ratio is determined with the gradient method.